Once upon a time, there was a young princess. She grew tired of the novelty of her father's power and of the privileges it afforded. She decided to run away. But in her journey, she became lost. The woods grew cold and void of life. She was scared. She would remain here until someone from the outside world came to rescue her. It was here that she waited, until the end of time, longing for the life she had once discarded. The princess's father was very upset at her for running away, but he loved her very much. So he went to the village and sought out any of the noblemen who would be willing to venture into the unknown woods in search of his lost daughter. The town butcher, a skilled tracker and hunter, was the first to set out on the king's quest. He was never heard from again. An artist from the village went in search of her, for in his eyes, no beauty on earth matched hers. He too went missing, as if plucked from the earth. With all hope lost, the king was in despair. His most loyal guard ventured out that night, determined to wait at the mouth of the woods, ready to meet any person who may cross his path. He was prepared to wait an eternity. He never left his post, and so the king would remain alone in his castle forevermore.
I'm older and you never catch me.
Okay, fine.
100. 99.
98.
97. 96. 95.
Found you.
Nope, I found you.
You are good, Sissy.
I told you, never mess with the best.
Can I take him? Mom said I can take a lost toy if it doesn't seem like anyone's looking for it.
Evelyn is not our mother. She's our stepmother. Do you know what our real mom would have said? She would have said you could. But what if he's waiting for someone to find him?
You're right. If I took him, whoever was looking for him would think he was lost forever.
You got such a big heart, baby girl. Come on, let's go.
Thank you.
This can't be real.
Ah, hello, my dear. Come closer so I can see you. Now, my dear, what is the matter? What a beautiful subject to be shedding such tears.
It must be a beautiful night for painting.
Oh, certainly. But it is very rare to find such a beautiful specimen as yourself.
Where are we?
If I told you, I doubt you'd believe me.
Wait! What are you doing? Wait!
Now, stay put while I get your likeness. Now, let me see what you are made of. Such ugly memories. Such a pretty girl. Have your memories poisoned your beauty?
I don't understand. Now you look in the mirror.
Clever girl.
Ah! Abby! Where have you been? Where's your little sister? I looked back at the car. We were worried sick.
Not keep them alive, then I shall no longer require your services.
My apologies. Once it is gone, I cannot help myself.
Restraint, my pet, is a virtue, even among the damned.
No.
Now, who might you be?
I'm a father. I have two beautiful baby girls.
I'm sure they're exquisite. Hush now. Come to me. Say, you catch more flies with honey than vinegar. You're so alive. Beautiful. I envy your life. Come to me. I'll show you where your sister is.
How did you know who I was looking for?
I was once a wandering sheep, just like you. I found myself in this place, very much like you. This place, this void, craves life, and after a while, so do all who have been trapped inside it.
She's not marked. I cannot kill an innocent.
You fool! I command you to bring her to me. She is in my web, and I want my prize. If you won't take her, I will.
If you do this for me, I'll give you everything you ever wanted. All the pain you could ever taste, you can have it. Please, dear.
Bella!
Shh. You don't want to wake her.
I'll do whatever it takes. Just tell me what I need to do.
I didn't think that this story would have a happy ending, did you? You played your part perfectly, Abigail. I must commend you.
Where is she?
Oh, Abby. Misery awaits those who lose track of their time, of which you have none.
Just tell me she's okay.
The story, Abigail, has lost itself inside its pages.
One by one, I drew them in. There were men who wished for my hand and came after me.
In life, they gladly laid down their lives for my love. In death, nothing holds them back.
I stopped them.
No. They do my bidding. I brought you to me. I brought you here.
Why me?
Well, someone has to pick up the mantle. And now you get to live forever, just like your fairy tales. One day, people will read about your story, your legend. But when they come looking for you, there'll be nothing left to find.
Once upon a time, there was a young princess. She grew tired of the novelty of her father's power and of the privileges it afforded. she decided to run away.